What's up, YouTube? Carlo here. Welcome to the vlog. This is the channel where we talk about sneakers and tech. And for this episode, I'm going to help you decide on which of these three sneakers you should get. This is the Element React 55. This is the Nike EXP-X14 React also. And of course, we have the Epic React Flyknit. At the very end of the video, we will also be drawing the winner of my raffle for the brand new Epic React Flyknit. So make sure you stay tuned until the very end. If you guys haven't subscribed to the channel yet, you absolutely have to do so because we are giving away Adidas Pure Boost brand new in your size the moment we hit 40,000 subscribers. Subscribe now, follow me on IG, guys. For anything, I just have to get a few things out of the way. I mentioned in my previous vlog that I entered the raffle for the Justin Timberlake Jordan 3s over at Titan. I joined the two pools. One is the free pool. All you had to do was to go to Titan 4 to be able to join the raffle. And I also joined the second pool, which is their Premi raffle, wherein you had to buy a Jordan 3 to be able to qualify and join that particular pool. I got a few questions asking which pair did I cop. Just wanted to show you guys, this is the Jordan 3 Hall of Fame or Katrina pair. The reason why I ended up copying this one, and I know to those who've been following me on this channel, I actually had a pair of this already, but I wanted to try selling on StockX. So the pair that I bought from before, I never actually even got to use. I just ended up selling it on StockX to be able to do the vlog on how you can sell on StockX if you're here in the Philippines. Anyway, that's it. This is the pair that I ended up copying and will be using for the next few days. Let's get to the comparison. So how I will do it is I will do pros and cons of each pair. We'll start with the XP-14. We'll do the Element React 55. And we'll end with the Epic React Flyknit. And then at the very end, I'll give my recommendation on which pair you guys should get, depending on what your needs are. So let's get started. This is the Nike EXP-X14. And this is probably one of the most underrated lifestyle sneakers that came out this year. Now, let me get one thing out of the way. This is not a running sneaker. There are a lot of things about it that make it look like a running sneaker, but don't get deceived. It is not. It is a lifestyle sneaker. It is a casual sneaker. It is a pair of kicks that you use to walk around and style yourself up. What are the things that I love about the EXP-X14? First things first, I love the look. I mean, the OG throwback to the vault colorway of Nike, that bright orange thing along the side, the suede material here at the back, the way they constructed the upper with the mix of translucent and mesh is just really so win in my book. It is a fantastic sneaker. It has so much character, it has so much pop, and it has so much vibrancy to it when you wear it. It's just an overall fun pair of sneakers to wear. The second thing I love about it is the comfort. You see this part at the back, this is all React, guys. This thick part at the heel is like equivalent to like the Ultra, not the Ultra Boost, the EQT Boost 9317, where you have a thick glob of Boost for Adidas. Here you have a thick glob of React technology here at the back. And lastly, I feel that this sneaker will hold up over time. It will age well, mainly because it has really good outsole. So you have that thick rubber outsole here covering the React midsole that you guys see here at the back. So those are the good things. What are the bad things about it? There are two main problems that I have with the sneaker. The first one is that the forefoot is a bit hard when you are stepping forward. It kind of reminds me a lot of the POD 3.1 from Adidas. You have that thick Boost material at the back, but then it transforms into your simple TPU material at the forefoot. That's the reason why I think this isn't as comfortable as the Nike Element React 55, because the React concentration is really here at the midfoot and at the heel. When you go to the bottom part, you barely see any React here along the forefoot of the sneaker. It's really that foam, and then it transitions into the rubber outsole. So that's number one. Number two, I don't know if it's just me being personally flat and wide feet, but I have stability issues with this sneaker. If I'm walking in them, there's a tendency for me to lose balance. I don't know if it's how they built the midsole and the outsole shape. It's not friendly for people with flat feet. So yeah, those are the two main problems that I have with the EXP-X14. But But guys, this is a fantastic shoe. If you can try it on in the store, there are different colorways already that you can pick from. There are more subtle ones also. Try it on, walk around in them. If you don't have the stability issue that I'm talking about, this is one of the best lifestyle casual sneakers that you can get today from Nike. Second sneaker I want to tackle, of course, is my newly reviewed Nike Element React 55. Link down below just in case you guys haven't seen my review yet of this sneaker. Let's jump right into it. Two things that I love. Number one is the unparalleled comfort. This is a really comfortable sneaker to wear. It has thick gloves of React for the entire sneaker, especially even here at the forefoot. So you have thick gloves at the back, you have thick gloves of React in the middle, and you have a respectable amount of React even down to the forefoot. And I think that's the reason why it's a good sneaker, because it lives up to the spirit of why the React technology was invented in the first place. As I mentioned in my review, when they were building the React technology, they really wanted it to be the perfect cushioning, comfort, casual, everyday lifestyle pair of kicks. So what they did was they analyzed your foot, people who would actually walk a lot throughout the day, and they identified the places where it would have the most amount of pressure and stress. And then they designed it, they drilled holes, they put support, they put better cushioning, depending on what they saw with their data. So that's why I think this is a really comfortable sneaker, because it's backed up with a lot of research. Number two, I just love the design. It's subtle. It's not as loud. Yes, the blue is a bit loud, but hey, it's something that gives it a little more pop. But I love the character, because you have a lot of elements in this sneaker mixed from mesh, suede, and that exposed stitching gives it a very deconstructed off-white vibe. So what do I don't like about the Nike Element React 55? I feel that this is a sneaker that won't age well, especially when it comes to the outsole. I've only worn it for probably 2 days, and it's really already taking a beating, as you guys can see there in the middle. Now, granted, it's not as abused as a lot of my other sneakers. I just have this bad feeling that come over time, this outsole will look really ugly, mainly because it will just take so much of a beating. Also, the creases are starting to intensify, but that's okay, all sneakers crease anyway. But that my main problem really is I have doubts and reservations on the durability. Lastly, we get to the Epic React Flyknit. Of course, there are different iterations of this. There's the more affordable Odyssey React, and there's the most affordable version called the Legend React. The Epic React Flyknit puts a lot of the best technology that Nike has in one sneaker. You have the Flyknit upper, which just gives you that one-to-one feel with your foot. You have the React technology here at the middle. And yeah, the combination of those two things really makes it a nice sneaker for performance, lifestyle, or, you know, just running. It's an all-around super versatile sneaker. And that's what I love about the Epic React Flyknit. It is your sneaker that does everything. You can run in them, you can work out in them, you can, I don't know, dance in them, you can style them up. There are a lot of colorways to pick from. So it's, for me, it's like the penultimate athleisure sneaker. And it's just ₱1,000 more expensive than the Element React 55 or the the EXP-X14, which gives it a much bigger advantage compared to those two sneakers. Because these two sneakers, the EXP-X14 and the Element React 55, aren't built for performance. And when I say performance, they aren't built for working out. You can probably try running in them, but it won't be the best experience ever. So that's my main reservation with these two sneakers. The best thing about this sneaker is that you get a lifestyle sneaker, you get a stylish sneaker, but at the same time, when you want to hit the gym or when you just want to run come evening time or in the morning, this will do the job very well. Which leads me to my recommendation. If you have one, if you just have budget for one sneaker, I'd really recommend that you just save up that extra ₱1,000 and go for the Epic React Flyknit, mainly because it delivers everything that you will need. Caveat though is that you'll probably have to take care of it. You'll have to clean it regularly, especially along the sides, because the dirt that accumulates here at the outsole has a tendency of creeping up along the sides of the midsole. So it will give a semi kind of dirty look if you don't clean it properly, especially if you're going to take it out for an athleisure or a casual date or a night out with your friends. Now, it gives extreme value because of that point, that it is so versatile. And if you can't afford the extra 1,000, you might want to consider checking out the more affordable option, which is the Odyssey React sneaker from Nike as well. But let's say that the Epic React Flyknit is not part of the equation, and you just had to pick between the EXP-X14 and of course the Element React 55. Which one should you get? At the end of the day, for me, it boils down to a style decision on your end. I mean, because it ultimately, these are two different looking sneakers, whatever way you look at it. So if you want the more traditional build of a sneaker with a pop, as well as a extreme all-around cushioning, then the Element React 55 is the pair that you would probably want to cop. If you want a very avant-garde different sneaker that really pops, then you have the EXP-X14. Personally, if I had to pick between the two, I'll end up going with the Element React 55 only on the basis really that the comfort is all around and it doesn't give me stability issues. My issue again with the EXP-X14 is that my flat feet are not friendly with it. As in, there are really times that I feel off balance with this pair, which I don't get with the Element React 55. And now is the time that we pick the winner of our IG contest for the brand new Epic React Flyknit. So as you guys know, I did an IG giveaway when I hit 30,000 subscribers. So now I'm gunning for a 40,000 subscriber giveaway with a brand new Adidas Pure Boost. So let's get started and figure out who won this contest. And the winner of our Instagram raffle for the brand new Epic React Flyknit is ConceJohn27. Congratulations, bro. I'll get in touch via IG. Then let's figure out the way how I can send you your new sneakers. And there you have it. Congratulations again to the winner. And guys, to those who didn't win, don't feel bad. We still have a lot of contests coming your way. And we have the Pure Boost giveaway on 40,000. I actually have some surprise giveaways planned in the middle of this journey to 40K that don't entail reaching a certain milestone. I'll just put them in videos like small Easter eggs that you guys will just suddenly, wow, there's a giveaway. So watch out for those. That's it for now. Now to end the video, I just wanted to share with you guys a clip of a concert, a surprise concert, if you will, that I found myself in when I was in Shang with my wife a few days ago. This is one of the most popular bands in the Philippines. They're called Four of Spades. And I just want to share with you a clip of them singing one of their more famous songs in Shangri-La, and they literally transformed the mall into some sort of giant karaoke video key session. That's it for now. I hope you guys enjoyed the clip of Four of Spades. Peace. God bless. Have a great weekend.